Module 28, Photo Etching, Apparatus and Materials. Zinc, copper or iron block, size 7 inches into 7 inches. Tracing and carbon paper. Etching, drawing needle, scrapper, metal file, brasso, sticker paper, black printing ink, stop out solution, inking knife, hard ground, inking glass, paper for printing, cotton rags and kerosene for cleaning, printing machine, hand gloves, mask, roller, hot plate, woolen felt, plastic tray, nitric acid, 60% purity. Select sketch photographic images and transfer this on transparent paper. Etching is a part of process of integral family along with an equitant. The process of etching was developed by German artist Daniel Hofer during the time duration between 1470 to 1536. Along with etching, he also developed the techniques of engraving, mezzotint and aquatint among the integral methods of fine art printing. The process of etching was more easily adopted by artists and printmakers as compared to engraving. The principal advantage being the very little knowledge of metalworking was needed for etching, and anyone with a fair hand at drawing could easily practice etching to produce good results. Hence, etching became popular. The first dated etching is from 1513 by the Swiss artist Urs Graf, 1485 to 1529. But Albert Durer, 1471 to 1528, was also making etchings about the same time. In traditional etching, a metal plate, usually made from copper, zinc or steel, is coated with a waxy acid resistant substance called ground, upon which the artist draws his design with a metal needle, exposing the bare metal as he does so. The plate is then immersed in acid. The acid eats into the metal where it is exposed by the design, resulting in lines in the plate. The plate is then wiped clean of all the ground and the plate is inked using the same method as for engraving. Several artists are known to produce unique prints combining various methods of printmaking, like Rembrandt and Francisco de Goya. Daniel Hofer initially used the technique of etching in Augsburg, Germany, to decorate armor before actually using it for fine art printmaking. Now prepare the screen block with the chosen sketch and paint using acid-resistant ink on the zinc plate, or make the block as per commercial block maker instructions. Another noted innovator was the French printer Jacques Callot, 1592 to 1635, who made significant improvement in etching technique. To begin with, he invented the ecope, a type of needle with a slanted oval tip, which enabled etchers to produce a gradually rising line. Next, he designed an improved formula for the waxy ground used on the copper plate. This improvement resulted in deeper lines being made by the acid, thus extending the lifespan of the plate, and also minimized the risk of the ground being eaten into the wrong areas. Callot also experimented heavily with the stopping out technique. This involved allowing the acid to eat slightly into the whole part before covering it in ground and re-soaking it in acid, a process which facilitated the creation of shaded areas. Callot's advances were published in his Manual of Etching and disseminated throughout Italy, Holland, Germany, and England. In 1746 to 1828 in Spain, Francisco de Goya, one of the world's most influential printmakers, was the undisputed leader of Romanticism art movement. The block is now to be etched using a mild nitric acid solution. This is the etching solution. In 1799, he produced a series of 80 etchings entitled Los Capricorns, commenting on a range of human behavior. In 1812-15, following the Napoleonic War, he made a set of Aquitaine prints called the Disasters of War, depicting scenes from the battlefield. The prints remained unpublished until 1863. In the intaglio process of etching, another development was of photo etching. The process remains more or less the same, but the end product is finer evolved and photographic print with intense tonal values. A piece of original artwork, photograph, drawing, collage, or whatever is reproduced onto transparent or translucent film or paper, then exposed onto a light-sensitive plate. The emulsion on the plate hardens where it receives exposure and will resist acid in the etching process. To prepare the etchant, mix carefully 1 part nitric acid with 14 parts water in a plastic tray. The nitric acid is 60% purity. Gently put the block into the acid bath in the tray. The softer areas will be eaten away and will become the recess which will hold the ink. Photo etching or photo intaglio goes back to the origins of photography. In the 1820s, Nipp invented a photochemical process using synthesized pewter plate. He called the image produced from these plates holographs. Daguerre and Fox Talbot made their own contributions a few years later, and photograph, a form of photo intaglio, became a commercial process for reproduction in the late 19th century. During the height of the photo session, Alfred Stieglitz used photogravure in his periodical camera work. Both Peter Henry Emerson and Alvin Langdon Coburn chose photogravure as a means of printing of their pictorialist images. The traditional photo etching method makes use of pre-synthesized zinc plates and an acetone developer. After exposure, the recesses are forming by an acid etch. The light-sensitive zinc plate is exposed in contact with a positive image. The plate is developed in chemical developer, which is an acetone with dye. The portions of the plate which retain color will form a resist to acid. The plate is rinsed and dried and then put into acid bath. The acid bites into the unexposed areas, forming recesses. The plate is rinsed and dried, inked and wiped, and run through an intaglio press in contact with damp paper. The ink is forced out of the recesses forming the print. Anupam Sood. Artist Anupam Sood was born in Hoshiarpur, Punjab in 1944. She now lives in Mandi, a small community on the outskirts of Delhi. However, Sood spent most of her youth in the former British summer capital of Simla in Himachal Pradesh. The time taken for a normal etch to act upon the plate is 20 minutes. In those times, for a young woman of some social standing, Sood's choice of a career in artistic pursuits over an arranged marriage was seen as brave and rare, and she belonged to a conservative family. Sood studied at the College of Art, New Delhi from 1962 to 1967. During the same decade, Somnath Hoare was retooling and revamping the college's printmaking department. She became one of the youngest members of the Group 8, an association of artists at the college founded by their teacher Jagmohan Chopra, and it was dedicated to furthering an awareness of printmaking in India. Sood later studied printmaking at the Slade School of Fine Art, University College, London from 1971 through 1972. It was after her return from Slade that Anupam Sood developed an intense interest in exploring clothed and unclothed human figures through the medium of etching. Anupam found inspiration in both male and female sexuality and identities. After the block is etched for 20 minutes, remove it carefully and clean the surface using kerosene, benzene or spirit. Overt takes on social issues are seldom found in Sood's art, and her figures are often self-absorbed and brooding. However, through symbolism and metaphor, Sood engages with socially relevant themes and moody depictions of interrelations between the sexes are a favorite topic in her work. Sood's etchings are made with the use of zinc plates, a difficult medium that requires both patience and precision. In one of her best known bodies of work, the Dialogue series, she expresses human communication between people of various sexes through a mood of mature, silent acceptance. The dialogue series emphasizes human togetherness as intimate and non-verbal. Sood's work is in the collection of the National Gallery of Modern Art, New Delhi, the Victoria and Albert Museum, London, the Peabody Museum, USA, and Glenbara Art Museum, Japan. Now to prepare the ink to be used on the block. A few drops of black ink is poured onto the inking glass. A few drops of linseed oil are added to the ink. Using a brayer or a roller, the ink and oil are mixed on the inking glass. Now this ink is ready to use on the block. Anupam Sood is one of the finest printmakers among the new generation of artists in India. Although she has taken up painting on large canvases, mostly in acrylic, her intaglio prints still hold their sway over her paintings. Anupam has been experimenting in different areas of the graphic medium, but what stands out is apparently her effortless infusion of different intaglio processes with screen printing and lithography. Instead, her family-drawn figuration of man and woman draw our attention to the general human situation and to psychological tensions between man and woman and that between man and society. A large part of charm of her intaglio and mixed media prints lies in her treatment of chiaroscuro. About her works, she has to say, "My print images can never convert into painterly images for the canvas, as the working body itself rebels." When images enter my mind, I see texture that belong either to etching or to painting. I see no easy conversions as the basic temperament of each process varies and so do ways of arriving at the end result. Working mainly with intaglio prints, Sood fuses her knowledge of different intaglio processes with lithography and screen printing. Her zinc plates breathe with a life, now suggesting the contours of a sculpture, now hinting at the warmth of oils. But at all times, restraint seems to be the keynote of her work. While her sympathies and concerns are often feminist, a recurring theme in her work is the common human predicament. Her subjects are often introspective and fatalistic, existing in a world that is falling apart. She acknowledges many influences. Her father, who had a love of bodybuilding, detective stories, Punjabi theatre, and her mother, who appreciated classical music and read the Upanishads. She also grew as an artist under the guidance of Somnath Hoare in Delhi, whose work she closely related to. More metaphorical than direct, her work in different forms that of traditional printmakers, in that she does not rely on the monochromatic quality inherent in this medium to make a statement. Anupam's work has evolved in phases. From the rather architectural forms, limbs and human figures in the mid-1970s to largely feminist subjects to the late 1970s. As one of the founder members of Group 8, 1968, Anupam, with her printmaker colleagues, worked through this association to promote and sustain printmaking as an independent, expressive art form. It should be noted that the intaglio process fills up ink in the block crevices, and the upper relief surface area should be wiped clean and over the edges too. Her work has been widely exhibited and appreciated. Apart from over a dozen solo shows all over the world, she has participated in many group exhibitions in cities in US, UK, Italy, Korea, Switzerland, and other countries. She has won numerous national and international awards for her excellence in printmaking. She has also conducted workshops in Canada and Japan. She lives and works in New Delhi. Health and safety precautions. One, store concentrated nitric acid and potassium chloride separately from other chemicals. Whenever possible, use diluted acid. Acid etching should be done with local exhaust ventilation. Second, an important safety rule when diluting concentrated acids is to add the acid to the water, never the reverse. Third, wear appropriate gloves, goggles, and protective aprons or lab coats when handling acids. If acid is spilled on your skin, wash with lots of water. In case of eye contact, rinse the eyes with water for at least 15 to 20 minutes and seek medical attention. Fourth, cover acid baths when not in use. Fifth, nitric acid action releases the respiratory irritant nitrogen dioxide, which has poor odor warning properties. During the etching processes, flammable hydrogen gas is also produced. Concentrated nitric acid is a strong oxidizing agent and can react with many other chemicals, especially solvents or other organic compounds, to cause a fire. Sixth, concentrated acids are corrosive to skin, eyes, respiratory system, and gastrointestinal system. Dilute acids can cause skin irritation on repeated or prolonged contact. Concentrated nitric acid is a strong oxidizing agent and can react explosively with other concentrated acids, solvents, etc. Nitric acid gives off various nitrogen oxide gases, including nitrogen dioxide, which is a strong lung irritant and can cause emphysema. Seven, always work in a well-ventilated area. If in a closed space, keep the windows open at all times. Eight, read the safety, handling instructions and caution labels on nitric acid bottles and containers carefully. Nine, always wear acid resistant gloves, safety goggles, apron and respirator while handling acids. 10th, in the case of an accident or your need for assistance, make sure someone else in the room is aware of what you are doing. 11th, should the acid solution splash or come in contact with skin and is allowed to remain in contact with skin, the result will be a severe burn. It can be washed off immediately with plenty of water and follow these general guidelines. Always keep a container of cold water nearby in cases of an accident. If your skin comes in contact with the acid, wash the area immediately with plenty of cold water and soap for a minimum of 15 minutes. Get a medical attention. Take the trial proof, check the design and tonal values printed. If your body should come in contact with the acid, wash your entire body with the hose from the draining sink for a minimum of 15 minutes. Get immediate medical attention. Modern acids and inks can be water-based or solvent-based, and hand care has to be taken that if a student has any respiratory allergies, asthma problems, appropriate aeration is provided. Now take the final print on the ready damp paper. Etching needles and tools should be stored safely, and one should always cut away from your silk. In advance, locate the nearest first aid box. When possible, clamp down plates to avoid slipping. Minimize the chance of carpal tunnel syndrome by choosing tools with wide handles, avoiding tight grips, and including hand flexing exercises during regular test periods. Set work table height so wrist flexing motions are minimal. Sharp metallic tools for techniques like dry point, etching, engraving, and mezzotint have to be used carefully and with a firm hand. Keep sharp tools under lock and key. Rosin powder is a fine dust which can get into the respiratory system easily. While dusting the block, always keep the nose and mouth covered and eyes too. Mark the addition number on the paper. Write all the details like date and signature on the print.